Ignalina two units were a crucial part of our electricity system, as it was supplying almost all our country needs, and Lithuania was an exporter of electricity.
When the EU and Lithuania negotiated the accession treaty, they agreed that the Ignalina reactors had to be closed and that the EU would contribute adequately to the cost of decommissioning and the reorganization of the energy sector. Decommissioning is a long-term and highly complex process. It requires an integrated process of design, engineering, fund management, licensing and technical support.
Whatever you see as facilities, buildings and equipment inside, all of it will have to be dismantled, then fragmented, then decontaminated. If it's impossible to decontaminate, then it will be put in either long-time storages or repositories and landfills. So all the fuel would be stored in casks and then later on transported to this facility, as you see, and then stored here for 50 years until the final disposal. And EBRD is managing the Ignalina International Decommission Support Fund, and naturally they became administrator of the funds.
EBRD was playing a crucial role, assisting us with the decommissioning, arranging a financial flow, help of the donors, which was most important part for the closure, as without that Lithuania would not be in position even to start decommissioning and even to think about closing down Ignalina nuclear plant.
Current cost estimate is 2.6 billion euro, and this is up to 2038 when this will become a brownfield site.
After closure of Ignalina nuclear power plant, it made a huge, I would say, tectonic changes to our energy sector and asked us to completely redevelop our energy sector.
Elektrina was an old plant built in Soviet times. It was, besides Ignalina, the main generator of electricity in the country.
It's actually the largest power plant in Lithuania. This power plant, as of today, forms the backbone of Lithuanian energy sector. And this has been the case since Ignalina nuclear power plant has shut down. The Ignalina International Decommissioning Support Fund had a huge role to play in modernizing this facility. First of all, the fund provided the grants for modernization of the old unit, and also, more importantly, the new unit, the combined cycle gas turbine unit, was constructed. Also partly funded by Ignalina International Decommissioning Support Fund, managed by EBRD.
We are placed in the Alytus converter station, which is a part of the power interconnection Lithuania-Poland. The interconnection is very much important for Lithuania with regards to the security of supply. Now we have diversified source of supply and we form the common energy market here.
Lithuania can today rely on a more diverse and better connected electricity sector for its energy supply.
Our main task was to integrate into neighboring countries, to be secure, first of all, but now this shows a good example that the region can grow stronger together.
It's a huge success of the international community, primarily European Commission, the bank, and our partners in Lithuania.
Europe can get only stronger with connections. The more connections we would have, the stronger we would all be.